Phishing, smishing, vishing. Sounds like I'm trying to put my tongue twister skills to the test, right? Actually, these are a few cybersecurity buzzwords we want to become familiar with. Chances are, if you have a cell phone, you text, or use email, you have already seen at least one of these in action. Let's take a quick look at each. Email phishing is the most common type of phishing and has been around since the early 1990s.
This week on the Computer Chronicles, the secrets of email. We'll show you how to find someone's email address online. Need to access your email from a remote...
So why do people still take the bait? Easy. Cyber scammers profit from our personal information, so they craft email messages that can be tricky to spot, even for seasoned professionals. Most phishing emails appear to come from a company or an individual we trust, such as a bank, social networking site, or a credit card company. In the email message, we have the hook, otherwise known as the sense of urgency message, that entices us to click a malicious link or give up personal information. Have you ever answered a call from a number you recognized on your caller ID, but the caller was not who you were expecting, or you heard a pre-recorded message indicating your auto warranty is expiring soon? If so, you have experienced vishing. Don't feel bad about answering that call. Scammers use technology to manipulate the caller ID so the call appears to be coming from a local or a familiar number. Once they have you on the line, scammers pretend to be from the IRS, your bank, or another trusted organization. Over 18.7 billion text messages are sent worldwide every day. And cyber scammers have even taken advantage of this preferred method of communication by creating malicious text messages, otherwise known as smishing. With smishing, an automated message is sent to thousands of cell phones and appears to come from a trusted source with an urgent message. For example, a text from a shipping service with a link to track and schedule delivery for a package, or a reputable company offering cash for completing a survey. Bottom line, clicking the link will download malicious software on your phone or lead you to a fake site that requests your personal information. Unfortunately, cyber scammers are profiting from phishing, vishing, and smishing, and these scams are not going away anytime soon. However, we can stay a step ahead by being informed and knowing how to respond. Remember, attacks can only cause damage if you take the bait. So don't let those urgent messages trick you into clicking. Ignore messages from unusual or unexpected senders, and don't click on any suspicious links.